Hi, nobodies. So, it's been a fairly good day. It didn't start out really great, but I did go to therapy. And we discussed some things. It's a really good session. And on the way there, I didn't have much trouble driving. So, next time, I think that I'm going to be able to go without a co-pilot. And I'm really happy about that. My therapist seems to believe that the driving anxiety is basically like, if you look at anxiety and stress as a cup, you know, as water in a cup, when I would get to driving, that would just be enough to spill over. And that's why, you know, that I was under this stress of, for so many years, trying to do something, you know, trying to conform and be what everybody wants me to be. And it's exhausting to be what everybody wants you to be. You really just need to be yourself. Got into words with someone last night and this morning, and I was called selfish. I was told that, holy shit, you are your mother. So I mentioned this to my therapist. You know, not that the mother comment bothered me a whole lot, because I know I'm not like my mother. I mean, I'm similar. You know, I've got expressions like her. You know, it's kind of like when they say dogs look like their owners. It's the same way with kids. It doesn't matter, you know, what you learn expressions from the people who raise you. That's where you pick them up. And because, I mean, I've seen it with stepmoms that their stepkid will look. Will make the same look. And it's like, how are you not that kid's mom? So I knew, like, I am not just like her. She was unstable. She was selfish. She was cruel. I'm not cruel. Not intentionally. Just to be straight, telling somebody the truth, your truth, doing something that they don't like, is not being cruel. It's being real, being honest with yourself and with them. It's not cruel. It's cruel in execution. If you look at somebody and you say, I hate you, I've hated you forever, you know, get the fuck out of my life. That's kind of a cruel way to say I'm done. And I would never say that to anybody. I would never be that mean to somebody unless they really, really pushed me. And you know, you're looking at scorched earth there. Burned bridge. And that's not what happened this time. There was no, like, me wanting to say, I hate you, get out of my life. Nothing like that. But, you know, there's nice ways to tell people things, and then there's mean ways to tell people things. The fact that I choose to pussyfoot around and, you know, ease into things should speak for me not being cruel. You know, if I'm trying to soften the blow, then I'm not being cruel, because trust, I can deliver a blow. I can be cruel if I want to. It's in me. It's in everybody. Everybody can be cruel. So I said this to my therapist, you know, and she said that what he probably saw was me doing something for me, something that only benefits me. And yes, that is the definition of selfish. But she said, in the course of things, if they're not used to you doing for yourself, doing things just for you, it can really hit hard when you finally do. She felt that I don't, you know, I've spent so long not doing for me. You know, my birthday money goes to Christmas presents, not to me. You know, I take that money and I spend it on everybody else. Not because I'm a great person. Not, you know, I'm not bragging on me saying I always spend my birthday money on everybody else. Even if I say I'm going to spend it on me, I'm going to go to Goodwill and I'm going to have a blast, I end up buying for everybody else. I mean, I'll get stuff for me. Don't get me wrong. I get stuff for me. But I'll be looking at other stuff. I don't just look at stuff for me. I look at other stuff and I'll say, oh, such and such, this will be cool. Let me get this. You know, I look at things and I think about who, you know, if I see something that I know Tieran's into, I get it. And that's because it's my love language, is to give gifts. To see something and say, oh, you know, to always be thinking of the people I know, and giving them little trinkets here and there. So my current actions, the current stuff that I'm going through, which I really hate not saying, I'm stifled and I don't like that, but I have to watch what I say. But I'm doing stuff that benefits me. But I'm trying to do it with the least amount of damage. And that leads to the other point that she made to me. That in all of our sessions, she had noticed that most of the stuff I complain about is that I'm not being heard. I speak and nobody hears me. Things don't change. They stay the same. I'm inconsequential. That's how I've felt for the longest time, that I don't matter because people don't remember that I said, I don't like that. I don't want that. It's just always, you know, I don't care what you say. You know, why even bother speaking? And the thing is I want to be heard. I mean, if you love me, you'll fucking hear me when I say stuff. Instead of me having to repeat myself or get mad and not say anything. You know, there's all kinds of things that I'll say, I don't like this. And it keeps happening. But I don't say anything because I'm like, I've said it like 5-10 times. Doesn't do any good. Why waste my breath? So I just sit and stew about it. Feel disappointed, frustrated, you know, all of that. And it just goes down inside. I mean, I deal with it somewhat. But what I don't deal with when I do say, well, it's nothing new. I'm just saying I'm not being heard. And I don't matter enough to be heard. I don't matter enough to be unhappy. You know, because they don't hear me. They don't notice. They don't see. And I'm tired of not being heard. That doesn't make any sense to them. And it may not make sense to anybody other than me and my therapist. But I'm done. I am done with not being heard. I am done with repeating myself over and over again. You know, people don't know me. You know how many cat things I get for my birthday and Christmas? It's like that's all they think that I care about is cats. But I am so much more than cats. I've been bought necklaces. I don't wear necklaces. I've been bought earrings. I don't really wear earrings. I've got a couple of studs, but I don't really wear earrings because if they're not right, they make my ears puff up and this nasty smelling stuff comes out. Yuck. It's nickel allergy or something like that. But I lost my skull ones, which had like a back on them. They were starter. They were pierced ears. They were pierced earrings. And they had like a little back on them and they snapped in and I lost them. I lost one. So that's why I don't wear them. But I'm not a person who likes to put on earrings. It's like they're either in and they're staying in or I don't mess with it. Bracelets. Don't wear bracelets. Don't wear watches. But people don't notice that. They don't see. I like poetry. Very few people have given me poetry. I like books. But nobody asks me, what am I reading? What's it about? Do you think I'd like it? Nobody in my life cares. And I ask them things like that. And I feel like, why am I wasting my time? Not saying I'm wasting my time with my kids. My son does ask me these questions. My son does notice. My older daughter knows me fairly well. My middle kid, if she gives me a chance, she'll know me pretty well too. But they don't know me. And they don't hear me. And I'm tired of it. You know, if I have to go away to be important, then that's what I'm going to do. I want a fuller life. And my therapist believes that I'm on the right path. Maybe she doesn't like the particular path I'm taking, like some of the things I'm doing. But she understands the reasoning behind it, that I want to be sure about people. There's too much, people are too quick to do things in the real world, and mistakes get made, and things get confusing. And I'm trying not to be confused about people. So I'm seeing who's paying attention. I'm seeing who knows what I like, what I don't like. I'm seeing who cares to ask. What are you reading? What's it about? I'm gonna read that too. You know, what are you watching? Oh, I love that show. Did you see this episode? You know? What are you listening to? You know, I mean, just somebody who's genuinely interested in hearing me. And I mean, isn't that what everybody wants? You want to be heard? Well, it doesn't do anybody any good if you're trying to be heard and they're not listening, but you hear them and you do what they want. And you try your best to be all of the things that they want. And at the same time, you're sitting there like, what are they doing to do that for me? I don't know what I'm trying to say. It's just, I'm done. Trying that. A person's either interested in having a conversation with me or they're not. And I don't expect somebody to like everything I like, but I expect them to hear me. I expect them to know what I want to drink. what I like, you know. I mean, something as simple as I like caffeine-free Diet Pepsi, but that's not all I drink. So, why don't I have Diet A&W? I shouldn't put that on here. That sucks. I shouldn't do that. No, I am sorry that I mentioned that. Because it is the thought that counts. And thinking about me and getting these super hard to find 2-liter bottles of caffeine-free Diet Pepsi is difficult. It is not your fault if you don't notice that I drink Diet A&W trying to alternate. That is my fault for not making it more noticeable and not saying anything. But that's what it all boils down to, I think, is my anxiety over not being heard, not being seen. And that isn't about hovering over somebody and spending a lot of time with them. So I've always said, quality is better than quantity. Some people don't have a lot of time to devote to you. They don't. We got lives where there's jobs to do, there's kids to raise, there's all kinds of stuff going on. So it doesn't matter if you spend 3 hours with somebody or 30 minutes. It's all about the quality of it. If you're having a genuine conversation and you're hearing that person when they speak to you, then that's better than spending 12 hours with somebody who ain't listening, who isn't getting the point, because they hear what they want to hear. They hear what they comprehend. They hear what they think you mean. Instead of actually listening and saying, hey, can you clarify that? That's just my perception of things. But other than that, my session was great. My day was great. And I'm looking forward to tomorrow being a good day. And I hope that all of you had a good day. All you that don't watch me. And I hope you have a good night as well. Good night.